You know, MMA is big out there in Northern California, San Jose. You got the Diaz brothers. One of the big names in MMA is Ronda Rousey. What are your thoughts on Ronda Rousey as a female fighter, you know?
She's bad, man. She's bad. And, you know, everybody just waiting to see who could mess with her.
Yeah.
And right now, she just seems unstoppable. Yeah. But she's bad. I don't know. I'm waiting to watch her fight next, right? Another week or so.
You know, she's very brave. You know, she went out. She's very confident in herself. She went out to call Mayweather out. You know, what do you think? What are your thoughts on that?
Nah, she's a little out of line for that. But, you know, it's a lot of...
As a fighter, that's your spirit, you know, to feel like...
Yeah, that and media, you know, likes to instigate stuff and, you know, I don't think that's never going to happen, and it shouldn't happen.
It's not going to happen, but you think she was maybe a little bit too overconfident with those statements?
Well, if you don't know nothing about the ground game, what are you going to do when a goddamn judo expert, armbar fucking specialist, comes and tackles you and grabs your arm? What are you supposed to do when all you know is how to punch?
Yeah.
You know, honestly, she's probably going to break Mayweather's arm if they got in a fight.
Yeah.
You know, and this is the same way I see it in the UFC.
Yeah.
The only way somebody's going to beat her is if they knock her out with like a two-piece, three-piece, you know, just bam, and fold her. But she got so much heart, you know, she's a warrior. She'll probably get back up, or she'll probably, you know, hold you or tackle you, or, you know, I'm pretty sure she'll work her way through it. So that's the only way I see anybody beating her right now.
Yeah. Is there a lot of pressure for you being that, and you know, you're one of the main faces for Northern California to succeed in boxing? Is there pressure, or is just maybe a push for extra motivation?
Well, you know, it's a mixture, but I don't worry about, you know, stuff I don't need to worry about, you know what I'm saying? I don't got somebody that I'm fist fighting, you know, that's what I'm thinking about, how I'm gonna take his spirit and how I'm gonna crush him.
Now tell us about this, you just signed with Top Rank. How's that, when they gave you the call and they told you, do you want to fight for us? How did that go about?
You know, I was, of course, most definitely, right now, you know. And it's beautiful. Here we are today.
What can we expect now with from Guy Robb being with the powerhouse like Top Rank? What can we expect from the future?
Just expect me to keep getting better and better each fight, you know, take it one at a time, keep improving, and climb the ladder.
You know, one of the fighters that came out of Sacramento was Diego Chico Corrales. I know you definitely know him. What are your thoughts on Diego Chico Corrales?
One of the greats, man. Everybody loves Chico. One of the greats. Warrior, savage.
Was one of his favorite fights yours?
Man, everybody's favorite fight. It's Castillo and Gael Corrales. Everybody's favorite fight.
You had a fight just like that with Joel Diaz Jr. as well. You know, you got dropped two times, I think. You dropped him once. He came back. They stopped the fight. Talk to us about that fight. That was a great fight.
It was a war, man. We in there in battle. You know what I'm saying? We ain't playing. Sometimes it goes down.
Paulie Malignaggi versus Danny Garcia. How do you see that playing out? Philadelphia versus New York.
Probably, you know, probably he's very smart, but he ain't gonna win that fight, you know. Danny gets a lot of bad breaks, you know. But, you know, sometimes fighters make you look bad, and, you know.
How'd you see?
I'm actually a Garcia fan. I like him, you know what I'm saying? Did he lose that fight with Herrera? It could have, if he would have, you know, got the L, you know, he couldn't be mad.
Yeah.
But, you know, it worked the way it went, so.